Hello friends, welcome to BSc Agriculture. If you are coming to my channel for the first time, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Your subscription and likes are always motivating us. So let's move to the video. In this video, we are going to see about fundamentals of pathology. I am going to cover the topic parasitism in fungi. So while seeing about the parasitism types, there are different types. So in parasite, I am first going to elaborate about the obligate or biotropic parasites. So they are said to be the parasites which cannot be grown on dead or artificial media. So they always use it to require a living host cell to complete their life cycle. So for example, downy mildew, rust, viruses, as well as candidatus phytoplasma are some of the examples of parasitic organisms which use it to live only on the living host, as well as hemibiotropes. So these are some of the organism which used to having a characteristics like the biotropes. So but they also have to be able to grow on the dead cells. So they first used to attack and grow on the living tissues of the host plant, and they even grow to reproduce as well as reproduce on the host cells even if the host cells are dead. Example, leaf spot of fungi like Alternaria as well as Mycosporula are the best example for hemibiotropes, as well as the necrotropes or perithotropes. So these are the parasites which use to kill the host plant. So these parasites use to advance through the penetration and live saprophytically in the parasite. Example, Phytophthora species as well as Sclerotium rawlsii. So once these kinds of parasites are used to enter into the host plant, they use it to kill the living tissues of the whole plants. And symbiosis, we can able to talk about it, and while you can even able to classify those parasites as facultative parasite as well as the facultative saprophytes. So the facultative parasites, so which are said to be usually saprophytic in nature, but under some conditions they are converted into parasitic nature. So example, Pythium species as well as Fusarium species, as well as facultative saprophyte, which are usually parasitic in nature, but during some conditions they become saprophytic. Example, smut fungi as well as Phytophthora species. And even though the parasites which use to have different types based on how they are going able to grow on the host plant, so they are classified into two parasites, so based on how they grow as well as living in the host plant. So the first one is ectoparasite and the second one is endoparasite. So the ectoparasite is nothing but the host, the parasite which used to grow on the external surface of the host plant. So example, Erysipi species. And while saying about endoparasite, so these are the parasites which used to grow inside the host plants. In endoparasite, they are even classified into two types. So they are the intercellular as well as intracellular. So the intracellular parasite is said to be one in which they use to grow in between the cells. So they develop as well as grow and reproduce in between the cells of the host plant. Example, downy mildew, fungi, albugo species. But while seeing about intracellular species, so these are the parasites which use to penetrate into the cells of the host plant. So they use to grow, reproduce as well as function within the cells of the host plant. So these are the pictures. As I have told, the parasite which used to enters into the host plant cells and grow in the cells of the host. So they are said to be known as the intracellular as well as intercellular, which used to grow, reproduce as well as emerge in the gap in between the cells of the host plant. So as I have already told that the symbiosis, which is also known as mutualism. So some of the dissimilar organisms, example fungi as well as algae, so they are said to be known as the lichens, so which is also known as the environmental indicators. So they use it to have a mutual benefits. So they use it to form a close association in between the two microorganisms. So the examples are lichens, which is an environmental indicators. So these are the mutual association of fungi as well as algae. And the other is mycorrhiza, which is the mutual association of fungus as well as plant roots. And while seeing about the parasite, so we must need to know about the different types of mycelium bodies they use to present in the parasite. So they are ectophytic, endophytic as well as ectoendophytic. intercellular and intracellular. So these are the myceliums, which is the body type said to be present on the parasite. So ectophyte, in ectophytic parasite, they use it to present on the outer surface of the host. Example, the mycelium bodies are said to be present in the outer surface of the host. Example, Erysipelas as well as Capnodium, and endophytic parasitic mycelium. So which is the mycelium which use it to penetrate the host body as well as develop within the tissues of the host plant. Example, Cultotrichum rhizopus, as well as the ectoendophytic. So these are the parasitic where the host bodies mycelium are said to be found both in the surface as well as within the host cells of the plant. And even we can able to have two other classification. They are intercellular as well as intracellular. So as like as we see in the parasitic classification of how they grow. So intercellular, which is the mycelium bodies, so which is used to penetrate in between the cells, as well as intracellular, where the mycelium bodies are said to be found inside the cells. So these are the types you can be able to see the mycelium which is found in the parasites. So I have given the lecture notes in description. So please comment about our video as well as join us in the Instagram page. And if you like the video, like it and share it with your friends and subscribe to BSC Agriculture and hit the bell icon to get regular updates. So thanks for watching the video. I will catch you up in next videos.